We are asked to examine the tiles or base 10 blocks in the shaded area, then fill in the blanks below. When modeling whole numbers using base 10 blocks, it's important to define the unit. In this case, the unit is equal to one small square. If you actually have base 10 blocks in front of you, it would be one small cube in three dimensions rather than one small square in two dimensions. Notice how the given model has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 units. Next we have what's called a rod or a long. Notice how a rod is equal to 10 units or 10. This model has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rods. Next we have what's called a flat. One flat is equal to 100 units or 100. This model has 1, 2 flats. Recording the information below, we have 2 flats plus 5 rods plus 7 units, which means the whole number in expanded form is 2 times 100 plus 5 times 10 plus 7 times 1, which equals 200 plus 50 plus 7, which equals 257. So the base 10 number being modeled is 257. Let's look at one more example. Examining the given model, notice we have 1, 2, 3 units. Then we have 1 rod, which is equal to 10. And we have 6 flats, where each flat equals 100. Recording the information below, we have 6 flats plus 1 rod plus 3 units. In expanded form, the whole number is 6 times 100 plus 1 times 10 plus 3 times 1, which equals 600 plus 10 plus 3, which equals 613. I hope you found this helpful.